Governor Babagana Umarazulum started his engagement for the month of August with an assessment visit to farmlands along Maiduguri-Ngala Road to have a first-hand information on farming activities. Impressed with the level of farming activities going on.
It's very encouraging to see that areas that have not been cultivated for the last 8 years are now cultivated.
Governor Umarazulum took time and interacted with farmers and pledged his administration continuous support to them with tractors and other farming implements, as well as protecting them by strengthening the agro-rangers and other security groups to sustain safe farming activities across Borno State. Professor Babagana Umara told the farming communities of Borno State government plan of adopting liquid fertilizer as alternative.
We just received a letter from the National Security Advisor banning the usage of the urea as well as the nitrogenous phosphorus and potassium fertilizers. And it do not augur well for government of Borno State to procure it. But nonetheless, we are investing heavily on liquid fertilizers. Yes. And also, very soon we'll also distribute tractors and others. But by and large, I hope you have seen it, where we have distributed some agricultural inputs in Benishak. But we shall continue to support the farmers.
Similarly, in the month of August, Governor Babagana Umarazulum was in Tokyo on the invitation of Japan International Cooperation Agency, JICA, and UNDP on a study of post-conflict and recovery drive of Hiroshima in Japan with a view to fast-track same in Borno. At an address at the orientation ceremony in Tokyo, Professor Babagana Umara appreciated the government and people of Japan for the warm reception accorded the Nigerian delegation, saying he was on a similar mission in 2018 and 2019 and enjoyed their hospitality under the sponsorship of JICA and UNDP, and appealed for more support from the Japanese government to fast-track the total recovery of Borno and the Northeast Nigeria. Also, during the month under review, Governor Zulum has approved 30,000 Naira minimum wage for the 4,491 primary school teachers that were cleared by the Numeracy, Literacy and Competency Assessment Committee inaugurated by the Borno State Government. Professor Babagana Umara disclosed this when he met with the leadership of the organized labor in the state at the Government House Maiduguri, stressing that the first 1,000 trainable among the unqualified teachers willing to further their education will be given in service and will be enlisted to enjoy the minimum wage after successful completion of their studies.
I approve the minimum wage for qualified teachers be implemented effective August 2020. Then, on the issue of those that are not qualified, I think there is a need for us to have some decorum in the education sector.
Governor Umarazulum also directed for submission of comprehensive list of state civil servants as well as existing vacancies preparatory to the promotion examination and possible lifting of the embargo on promotion early next year. He urged critical stakeholders in the system to work together towards sanitizing the civil service in addition to pension issues, assured to look into other issues raised by the labor leaders and unveil a plan to engage the services of consultant to manage the payroll of local government councils. And in the month of August, President Muhammadu Buhari was in Maiduguri, the Borno State capital, to commemorate the 2022 World Humanitarian Day. President Muhammadu Buhari was received at the Maiduguri International Airport by Governor Babagana Umarazulum, his deputy Umar Usman Kadafur, the APC vice presidential candidate Senator Kashim Shatiba, members of National and State Assembly, top government officials and other stakeholders of Borno. President Muhammadu Buhari, in company of his host Governor Zulum and entourage, commissioned the teachers' quarters situated at Bulunkutu along Airport Road, paid homage on the Shehu of Borno, virtually commissioned the 500 resettlement houses for the displaced community in Mulai, about 20 km away from Maiduguri, the Borno State capital, and unveiled palliative to the displaced and vulnerable people. President Muhammadu Buhari also inspected different wires produced by the train internally displaced persons as part of recovery drive of government. Commissioning the houses, President Buhari described Governor Umar Azulum as passionate leader who has his people at heart and enjoined other governors to emulate him. The teachers' quarters is among capital projects delivered by the Professor Umar Azulum administration, comprising of 24 units of furnished two-bedroom flats and 6 blocks of story buildings, fully fenced, interlocked and landscaped to ease accommodation problem of teachers. It should be noted that the quarters is part of the 10,000 resettlement houses approved by President Buhari in 2021 to be constructed in the state, out of which over 6,000 have so far been completed. Professor Umar Azulum dropped this hint at the Shehu's Palace.
Words cannot adequately convey our debt of gratitude to you for the enormous concern, empathy, and support you have been rendering to the good people of Borno State since you assumed duty as the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Your Excellency, during your last trip, your promise to the people of Borno State to establish 50 megawatt power station. This project is undergoing and is nearing completion. Inshallah, in the next few months, people of Borno State will have uninterrupted power supply. I'm pleased to inform this gathering that His Excellency President Buhari last week has approved the sum of 18 billion naira in favor of the Presidential Committee on Repatriation and Resettlement with a view to resettling our refugees that are living in the Republic of Chad, Niger, and Cameroon.
President Muhammadu Buhari, in a remark, commended people of Borno and the Shehu for the warm reception accorded him, stressing that his administration for the past 7 years has done a lot in the areas of security, provision of fertilizer to improve agricultural activities for Nigerians to produce what they will consume, noting that security in Borno and other parts of the country has greatly improved and are sure to do more for the well-being of Nigerians.
I am very pleased that those who are following the developments of the performance or lack of it of government know what the condition was here before this administration and the relative to time and the resources. Certainly this administration has paid the attention to this part of Nigeria because they deserve it. But we can encourage Nigerians to grow what they eat and eat what they grow.
Welcoming the President, the Shehu of Borno Alhaji Abubakar Ibn Umar Garbe Al-Kanemi appreciated the present administration for the relentless effort towards restoration of peace, rehabilitation, reconstruction and resettlement of liberated communities in the state.
Your Excellency, despite the resettlement of some of our displaced communities, especially in the Chad Basin region, the Chad Basin Development Authority for the first 8 years has not been operational as a result of insurgency and destruction of the pump and powerhouses. In view of the resettlement of return of displaced communities in the zone, it deemed it appropriate to prevail on Your Excellency to ensure the reactivation of the vandalized pump and powerhouses and perhaps facilitate the extension of the national grid to the area.
Alhaji Abubakar Ibn Umar Garbe Al-Kanemi commended Governor Babagana Umar Azulum for meeting the yearnings and aspirations of the people in the state. Speaking at the commemorative 2022 World Humanitarian Day at the Multipurpose Hall Government House, Maiduguri, President Buhari reaffirmed federal government's continuous support to victims of crisis and urged donor agencies as well as critical stakeholders to focus on emerging humanitarian shakings. President Muhammadu Buhari commended Operation Hadinkai and other security operatives for their efforts in combating terrorism and urged them to take the fight to their enclaves. The president enjoined world leaders to pay tribute to the humanitarian actors for sacrificing their lives, noting that increasing number of orphans and widows, hence the need to devise means that will take care of the emergency issue, and commended Governor Zulum's effort for complementing the federal government on humanitarian activities.
I urge the ministry and its agencies, as well as state governments and the sufficient committee I have set up under the chairmanship of the past president, to come up with specific programs and projects that respond to these emerging challenges of explosive ordinances, as well as that of children orphaned by insurgency.
Professor Babagana Umar Azulum appreciated the president for visiting the state, which he said is a clear demonstration of consistency to restore peace and unity, saying the establishment of Northeast Development Commission, the construction of a 50-megawatt power plant in Maiduguri, and the inauguration of Repatriation Committee are worthy of commendation.
I'm particularly excited and delighted for the singular privilege of hosting the number one citizen of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Mr. President, is here. Our friends from the international community are here. The presence of His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari gives us tremendous pleasure, because it is one of these singular acts of consistency in the support to bring Borno State back to complete normality. The President has been with us from the beginning in line with his promise, and has not even for once relented in the push to get Borno State back on its feet.
Also, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umara continued inspection visit to farmlands, this time around along Maiduguri-Dalwa-Dambua axis, to assess farming activities as it progresses in its quest to end the lingering insurgency, inculcate resilient and self-sufficient to the people. Governor Zulum was visibly impressed with the back-to-farm initiative of the state government, noted that all year-round farming activities is the best solution to economic recovery and self-reliance. With 90% of the Borno population being farmers, government will continue to support them to enhance farming activities and boost their means of livelihood.
And the only way we can address the challenges of insurgency is to ensure that the community will earn their means of livelihood by themselves. And here in this part of the country, over 90% of our population are farmers, and the only way we can engage them actively is to ensure that access is being created for them to go to their farmlands.
The governor took his time to go round the farms and interacted with farmers, saying he was impressed with the turnout and commended the agro rangers for providing security to farmers. Also in the month of August, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum said his government will not condone any form of misappropriation of government property by an individual or organization in the state. Professor Umar Azulum was speaking when he paid an unscheduled visit to Kashim Ibrahim College of Education, Maiduguri, following a report that some properties belonging to the college have been carted away by an institution. He said government decided to match Kashim Ibrahim College of Education with Borno State University to enhance quality of education, emphasizing that the closure of the institution does not in any way relate to poor performance, but rather to reduce cost of managing them, and directed that materials removed be returned immediately.
Henceforth, nobody is allowed to remove anything from this college.
Thank you.
And then the Commissioner for Education is hereby directed to ask directly State University to return any properties that they have taken away. We cannot vandalize this school. Instruction was given to see how we can manage, match the State University with other tertiary institutions in the state. It's not only University of Maiduguri, State University, especially in the areas of academic staff and non-academic staff.
Governor Babagana Umara emphasized that transferring staff of the college to Borno State University is by choice, adding that all principal officers will be placed in their appropriate places. Similarly, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umar Azlam has hosted the governor of Far North of Cameroon, Alhaji Mujinyawa Bakari, at the government house, Maiduguri. The governor recalled that the multifaceted crisis bedeviling the Lake Chad regions will take generations to resolve the challenges, saying, series of meetings were held with far-reaching recommendations such as addressing the security challenges, enhancement of livelihood and trans-border cooperation among the member states, among others.
During our last three visits to the Republic of Cameroon, especially to Marwa, for those that have been to Marwa with me, they have seen the way and manner the Cameroonians received us. The government of Nigeria, under the leadership of President Buhari, and the government of Borno State, under my leadership, will forever continue to partner with you and will cherish you for the wonderful relationship that exists between the two countries.
He lauded the government and people of Cameroon for their hospitality to the Borno refugees in that country, stressing that efforts are on to ensure the reopening of Maiduguri Cameroon route and the Bankie market, and appeal for support on the repatriation of Nigerians taking refuge at a neighboring country. The governor of the Far North Cameroon and chairman governors of Lake Chad Basin Commission, Mujinyawa Bakari, noted that his visit was follow up to the resolution reached by member states in October last year. He said, several issues presented to development partners were revalidated at the meeting and sanctioned by a communique, which informed his decision to visit member states with a view to assess actions or inactions taken on implementation of agreement reached. Alhaji Mujinyawa thanked President Muhammadu Buhari and his Cameroonian counterpart, Mr. Paul Biya, for their assent to the trans-border cooperation geared toward addressing the security challenge, infrastructural deficit, and enhanced trans-border cooperation among the member states.
Their personal engagement in the fights against trans-border insecurity in the Lake Basin, attachment to the ideas of peace and durable development have remained major secret challenges. Let me also use this opportunity to magnify the quality of relations which characterize the good neighborliness between the Far North region of Cameroon and the Federal State of Borno, sharing a common border, signify the similitude of security challenges, economic growth, and sustainable development.
Also in the month of August, Governor Babagana Umara met with the leadership of the Academic Staff Union of Tertiary Institutions and that of the National Association of Nigerian Nurses and Midwives in Borno State with a view to restore the glory of teachers, the education sector, and that of health workers. The governor made his position known when he met with the leadership of the two unions at the government house, Maiduguri, saying, as a university lecturer and a former rector, Ramat Polytechnic, he will ensure the sustenance of successes recorded in the two sectors. Also, during the month under review, Professor Babagana Umara inspected flood-prone areas in the state capital and pledged to engage experts to provide holistic solution to the perennial flooding in the state. He said, government will make provision in the next year's budget to ensure that the problem is addressed once and for all. Governor Zulum sympathized with residents of 505 Housing Estate, whose houses were submerged following a heavy downpour, and directed the Flood Control Committee to liaise with the Urban Planning and Development Board and come up with a measure to mitigate the problem.
So what we need to do is to see how we can involve the Town Planners Association. I want them to meet with the Flood Control Committee so that we shall design, come up with a complete master plan for the provision of drainages that will ensure my degree of flooding in a holistic manner.
Professor Babagana Umar Azlam was also at the water outflow channel behind Mohammed Lawan College of Agriculture, where he commended the flood control committee for their quick intervention. Also in the month of August, Governor Babagana Umar Azlam traveled to Mangano to enroll school-aged children, most of whose parents were either killed or dropped out during the Boko Haram insurgency. The governor, who led the enrollment of 4,229 children, said, "This time around, we are targeting the enrollment of 10,000 children, displaced persons from Mangano, Kukawa, Guzamala and Merte local government areas, all in northern Borno." He applauded parents and guardians for presenting their awards for the mass enrollment, saying, "With sound education, the community can prosper."
Education is key. Education is key. Changer. One of the root causes of the insurgency, as I've been saying it, is illiteracy. So we are here to see how we can tackle one of the root causes of the insurgency, which is illiteracy. And that has informed the decision of Borno State Government to enroll as many as possible, especially the dropouts, to school.
While in Mangano town, Governor Umar Azlam took time to visit the ongoing construction works at the Federal Polytechnic Mangano ahead of the commencement of 2022 academic session, where he inspected the lecture halls, offices, hostels, staff quarters, and directed for the construction of additional hostel, staff quarters, and admin block. The governor also inspected the ongoing construction of zonal office for monitoring and evaluation of government establishments. From Mangano, Professor Babagana Umara traveled to Cross Kawa, a commercial center between Kukawa, Mangano, and Baga, hitherto captured by the Boko Haram insurgents, and was liberated in July 2020 by the Nigerian military and other security operatives. On his way to Cross Kawa, Governor Zulum was impressed on the turnout of farmers moving to their farms, acknowledged the resilience of the people, and assured that government will do its best to provide their basic necessities of life. While in Cross Kawa, Governor Zulum took time to go round the market, fraternize with the community, and express gratitude to Allah for the return of peace.
This is Cross Kawa Market, and we are right now inside the cattle market. You have seen how busy the market is. Cross Kawa is located to the far north of Maiduguri, extreme northern part of Borno State. You have seen normalcy has returned to Borno State, and then government of Borno State will continue to strengthen the resilience of the cohesion with a view to promoting peace building, social cohesion and stability in the entire state.
He commended the security operatives for their effort in ensuring the return of peace across the state. Similarly, Governor Babagana Umara received the executive chairperson of Federal Character Commission, Dr. Muhibat Ankaka, commissioners and management staff at the Council Chambers Government House Maiduguri. The chairperson and the management of the commission were in Borno to flag off Northeast Zonal Sensitization Workshop on fostering cohesion among government agencies.
The task of Federal Character Commission is a pivotal and equal one, requiring the participation of all stakeholders. Its primary focus is to ensure a strong, vibrant, and indivisible nation based on fairness, equity, and justice.
Distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, may I, on behalf of the government and people of Borno State, register my appreciation and gratitude for the management of the Commission for choosing Maiduguri and Northeast as the focal venue for this occasion in view of the improvement in the security situation in the Northeast.
A gala night was organized to the visiting governor of Far North of Cameroon Republic, as well as the executive chairperson and management staff of Federal Character Commission in appreciation of their working visit to Borno State. Cultural dances with a display of royalty showcasing the unity, brotherly and neighborhood featured to entertain guests in line with Borno hospitality. In addition to that, some short meals and delicacy.
Thank you.